He's beefed with Eminem. He's played Tommy Lee in the Motley Crue movie, and he did a really good job at that. He's dating Megan Fox, and he's got a new album this week. What's up? I'm Adam Wilde from Virgin Mornings, and on Wilde Top 5 this week, we are profiling the best 5 songs of Machine Gun Kelly's career so far. Because remember, he's got that new album coming out. Let's start with number 5. Wild Boy featuring Waka Flocka at number 5, and this one's older. It's 2012 that this song came out. It's been a bit. Now, the reason that this is an important song is because it was one of the first ones that came out when Machine Gun Kelly was signed to Bad Boy, as in Diddy's record label. Story goes, he was doing a show at South by Southwest, and he impressed Diddy so much that Diddy walked backstage after the show and said, "I want to sign you." Machine Gun Kelly signed, and they're still working together to this day. Number 4 is actually his latest song, and it's a completely different sound for him. This is Bloody Valentine featuring Megan Fox in the video, and there's a story there. So obviously this is the first single from his new album, Tickets to My Downfall, and the video spilled a little bit of tea. Apparently Megan and MGK hit it off big time on set, or maybe they had before, but around the time this video came out, Megan Fox and her husband of more than 10 years, that's Brian Austin Green from 90210, said that they were splitting. MGK has said on social media that he is in love. Clearly it's with Megan, and I mean, honestly, watch the video. There's some chemistry there. Number 3 with Hailee Steinfeld is At My Best, the second song he ever did that entered the Billboard Hot 100. The first is one that's coming a little bit later in the chart. But this is an important song for him. He said, "This song's for anybody that feels like I did, never the cool kid. This song's for anybody who fought their way through and always remained true. This song's for anybody, the ones that are trying to get it and the ones that dream it and live it." Clearly it's about the struggle and making it, which brings us to number 2, big struggle. Now, one thing you need to know about Machine Gun Kelly is he's a passionate guy, and that makes number 2 particularly important considering it's a diss track aimed at Rabbit, as in Eminem. Yeah, seriously, these guys beefed a few years ago. Check this out. Eminem actually called out Machine Gun Kelly first for suggesting that M's daughter Hailee was hot as Now, that definitely is crossing the line, but it's worse when you find out that Machine Gun Kelly was 21 when he sent that tweet. Hailee, Eminem's daughter, was only 16. Not cool. Now, this happened again in 2012, years ago. Machine Gun Kelly had apologized for it, but 6 years later, Eminem torched him on his album for it, and MGK thought it was in the past, it bothered him, and he came out with this. It's pretty brutal for M. He calls out Eminem for being a bully, trying to get Machine Gun Kelly's music shelved, and sitting at home and reading the dictionary to come up with rhymes, rather than, you know, getting it from experience, which is what rap's supposed to be about. Now, I'm not sure if the two of them have ever resolved it, but one thing that has for sure remained unsolved: what kind of cereal Machine Gun Kelly is eating in that video? Because he keeps eating it, and the camera keeps panning to him, and nobody knows what he's eating. Somebody please ask this man. And number 1, this is easy. Machine Gun Kelly and Camila Cabello. A very special song for both of them. It's called Bad Things. Now, these days, if you do a collaboration with Camila Cabello, you're probably guaranteed to get somewhere into the top 10 on the charts. But when this song first came out, Camila was still in Fifth Harmony. And outside of Fifth Harmony fans, harmonizers, she wasn't exactly well known as a solo artist. But this song proved she could do it on her own. The combo was dynamite. Song went to number 4 on the charts, which was well above what anyone expected. And soon after, Camila announced she was leaving Fifth Harmony. And Machine Gun Kelly actually, in an interview, dropped a pretty interesting bit of knowledge. The day they received their gold plaque for this song, her split from the band was announced. He said, "It was odd that it happened on the day we got our gold plaque for Bad Things. It seems like the way it played out, it wasn't great timing. But I know it was all so genuine." And he did go on to say that Camila kept it above board when she left Fifth Harmony, despite the fact that the two sides were not really happy with each other for a while. However, Bad Things, huge for Machine Gun Kelly, was his first big hit, and it was Camila's first big hit on her own. That was all the way back in 2016. I believe that song's 4 years old. So that's why we're getting a new album from him this week, Tickets to My Downfall. We'll see if we add to this list with Machine Gun Kelly the next time we do it. I'm Adam Wilde from Virgin Mornings. Thanks so much for watching Wilde Top 5. We'll see you next time.